And now we will learn how to find and fix mistakes during the bank reconciliation process. This will be the third consecutive month of bank reconciliation, and we're imagining it's the same company that we did bank reconciliation for in the two previous videos. There are four mistakes in this file. You will find them as you do the bank reconciliation process. First, try to fix them yourself as you do the March reconciliation. See if you can get the numbers to match after finding and fixing all four of the mistakes. In this video, assume the bank is correct. Go slowly, be careful, and write down the mistakes that you see to make sure they're the same as the ones that I will show you. After you try it yourself, you can unpause this video and watch me do the bank reconciliation and find and fix the four mistakes as I go along. But right now I suggest you pause this video and try the March reconciliation yourself. So here's the March bank statement in the format of an Excel spreadsheet. Notice the beginning balance is $46,205.04. And if you remember the prior video, that was the ending balance of the February statement. We come back to QuickBooks and click Banking, Reconcile. Immediately we notice that the beginning balance listed here is different than the beginning balance from the statement. Something has changed. Notice it was last reconciled on March. Quickly notice that the beginning balance is actually higher than it was before. Now, in a situation like this, the way to find out what happened is to open the report called Reconciliation Discrepancy. Make sure it's for the correct bank account, and notice that check number 8, which was dated January 15th, was changed. The original amount was $925, and the effect of the change was positive $630, positive to the account. That means that whatever we did increased our bank account by $630. So can you figure out what the change was? If you figured it out, then you have figured out mistake number 1 out of 4. The discrepancy report showed that check number 8 from January 15 had been changed to an amount of $295 from $925. That's because if the bank account increased by $630 and this check was changed, that means that this check was decreased by $630, and therefore it has been changed to $295. Well, what do we need to do? We need to change it back. The quickest way to find check number 8 would be to click Edit, Find, and then choose Check, and then put number 8. Now check number 8 is in front of us, and we need to change it back to 925. Double click, change the amount back to 925. Of course, you have to make sure when you're in the check window that you change it in both places. Oh, it automatically changed it in both places, so you don't have to worry. Click Save and Close at the bottom, and don't worry about this message because we know what's going on and we know why we're changing this. We're changing it to fix it. So we click Yes. Now let's see if the problem is fixed. We click Reports, Banking, Reconciliation Discrepancy, click OK, and notice there are now no discrepancies on the Discrepancy Reconciliation Report. And when we click Banking, Reconcile, we notice that the beginning balance has been changed and fixed to become correct. The beginning balance listed here in QuickBooks now matches the beginning balance of the statement. Now let's continue the process the way we did before and see what other mistakes come up as we go along. Let's go ahead and enter the ending balance, which in this case is $64,597.51. So let's see if I'll be lucky enough to be okay, good. Now, the service charge. Remember, once we record it into QuickBooks, we have to mark it off on the statement. The service charge is $35 the way it normally was, and we mark it off with a nice shade of blue. Remember, we put it in as a positive number because QuickBooks already knows that it's negative. And the date in this case is March 26th. We came very close. Good. The interest we earned in this month was actually $127.27. Let's mark it off as we enter it into QuickBooks. 127.27. And the date that the interest was given was March 19th. Slightly different than the previous month. Now we're finished with the first window and we can click continue, and we are in the second window for reconciliation. Now in this window, let's just first see if the deposits are okay. We scroll up and we see the first deposit number 8 is 80,020. I happen to know that that matches here. Deposit number 8, 80,020, I mark it off in both places. The next deposit is deposit number 9, 17,840. And I happen to know that that's the same as deposit number 9 here. So I mark it off in both places. However, when I look at the statement, I do not see deposit number 10. Deposit number 10 is nowhere on the statement, and therefore deposit number 10 is a deposit in transit and should show up on the April statement next month. But because it's not a March deposit on the March statement, we will not mark it off. So now we're done with the deposits. Now let's go through the checks very carefully. The first check that cleared during March was apparently March 30th for $678.09. I happen to know that that's the same in both places. Check number 30, $678.09. Okay, be patient and stay with the story. Check 31 for $210.05. I happen to know is the same in both places. Check number 32 is $168.76. On the statement. However, when I look at check number 32 here in the computer, I see it's for $186.76. So I found somebody's mistake. Again, the check number 32 is $186 in QuickBooks, but it's $168 on the bank statement. Well, congratulations. We now found mistake number two. Mistake number two is the March 7th check for check number 32 to Verizon was transposed a number. It was supposed to be 168 and we accidentally recorded it as 186. What do we need to do? We have to change it back. No problem. So let's leave the reconciliation window because QuickBooks will remember the check marks that we placed. Let's remove this and go to the Finder to find check number 32. Edit, find, check, number 32. Here it is. Let's double click and change it to what it's supposed to be. 168.76, push tab. Notice it's the same amount in both places. We click at the bottom, save and close. Do you want to save the changes? Yes. Now let's go back and continue to reconcile. Banking, reconcile. QuickBooks remembers everything you put in the first window. Click continue, and QuickBooks remembers the previous check marks. Now that check number 32 is correct, we can mark it as cleared in the QuickBooks, and we can also mark it as cleared on the bank statement. Let's continue. Check number 16 is 570.33. I happen to know that that's the same thing here in the QuickBooks file. Check number 33 is 654. I happen to know that's the same as it is in the QuickBooks file. Check number 37 is 991.66 on the statement. However, when I look in the QuickBooks, I don't even see check number 37. Check number 37 has never been recorded in QuickBooks, so why is it on the bank statement? Well, congratulations. We found mistake number 3. Mistake number 3 is that check number 37 dated March 20 to Verizon for $991.66 was never recorded into QuickBooks. Maybe the bookkeeper wrote the check and sent it out and forgot to record it into QuickBooks. But the bank didn't forget. They paid Verizon and they put it on the statement. So what do we need to do to fix this? You have to record the check and then go back and reconcile. Let's close the reconciliation window, click Banking, write a check. The date of the check that we were supposed to record was March 20. It was check number 37. The amount was $991.66. And of course, the check was payable to Verizon. So now that you have all the information regarding the check, and now that you've recorded the check, I have no idea why it put the expense on a different line than the money amount, but this is the way the check is supposed to look when you record it. When we click Save and Close, we can just go back. Banking, Reconcile. QuickBooks remembers everything we put in the first window. Now we're back in the second window, and check number 37 is right here. Let's mark it as cleared in the QuickBooks reconciliation window, and let's also mark it as cleared on the bank statement. Now we can continue. Check number 29 for $75.76 is also here for the same amount. Let's mark it as cleared in both places. Check number 35 is $488.89. I happen to know that that's the same in both places. Check number 36 is $350 in both places. Check number 34 is $2,202.48 in the bank statement. And check number 34 is the same amount in the QuickBooks records, so I will mark both of them as cleared. Check number, I guess that's everything so far. Check number 38 is $410.11 in the bank statement. When I look at the QuickBooks records, I see check number 38 is the same amount, so I mark it as cleared in the QuickBooks records, and I mark it as cleared on the bank statement. Now, the remaining difference is $760.80 before I clear the very last check on the statement. The very last check on the statement is $760.80. That happens to be the difference before I mark the last one as cleared. So I'm going to mark the last one as cleared on the statement, which means everything has been marked off the statement. And at the moment I clear the last one from the statement, which was the 7680, boom. Ladies and gentlemen, now the difference is zero. Congratulations, you found and fixed all four mistakes. The other three checks that are still unmarked and the other deposit that's still unmarked are simply outstanding, and they will clear in the next month. We click Reconcile now, and we run our reports. and now we are experts in bank reconciliation.